We are beginning tonight with a graduation party that went terribly wrong. This weekend in Aptos, a party that was actually never supposed to be turned into a raucous affair with hundreds of people doing thousands of dollars in damage. And social media may have been the driving force behind it. Action News reporter Phil Gomez is live from Santa Cruz with tonight's top story. Phil?
Well, Aaron, we spoke with the owner today, and she tells us a quiet night of making cupcakes turned into much more, all because of a single text.
They had the cupcake mix out and a funfetti to decorate the cakes, and they were going to watch a movie on Netflix, and 15 minutes later, it all broke out.
Damage to the Aptos home on Flume Road was extensive. Drawers were rifled through, a gate broken. 17 officers showed up to move the trespassers out. The house was ransacked.
When deputies arrived on scene, they found 200 to 300 people inside the house or around the house. And when they went to the backyard, they saw open and empty rifle cases. Shortly after this, CHP conducted a vehicle stop and found some of the stolen property, of which was the rifles as well.
18-year-old Anthony Arroyo was arrested for the theft of the rifles, jewelry, and other items. Another minor was arrested for driving under the influence, and the house was thrashed. The mother of the 16-year-old girl did not want to be identified for this interview.
It's a mess. It's a mess. There's a lot of damages. There was a lot of theft. The house was ransacked. Drawers emptied. You know, people just went through everything. And I don't believe it was the 14-year-old kids.
This mother wanted to remind parents to talk to their kids and instill a sense of responsibility to friends and their property. Other parents agree.
I think they need to know that social networking is good, but at the same time, there should be some control.
Boundaries.
Boundaries, and there always has to be permission.
Santa Cruz County does have a social host ordinance on the books. People who host a party where alcohol is provided can be held accountable. The United Way of Santa Cruz County wants to remind people about it, especially during graduation time.
The ordinance holds individuals at the party who are hosting the party accountable for the people that are at the party and if they leave. So that means usually first time they'll get a warning. Second time they'll get a citation, and actually they'll receive a fine. They can also be accountable for cost to the city or county for retribution for law enforcement.
That law does not apply here, although the 16-year-old girl did receive a citation for noise disturbance.
I feel like that was wrong. She did not intend to have a party. She was a victim. We were all victims here. The people on the road were victims.
The homeowner guesses damage to the house runs in the tens of thousands of dollars. They were still cleaning up today. Dan and Aaron.
All right, Phil, thank you. By the way, there is more information on that social hosting and teenage binge drinking. You can find it at projectcurb.org.